In this video, I'll start the build of my ukulele by bending the sides of the instrument.
So I've got this piece of white oak that I'll try to use for the sides of my ukulele, and I'll try to resaw it with just a small blade, because coming from both sides, this thin blade should be perfect for the job. So now I need to rip a thin layer off of this board, and I set the blade to be a bit over half as high as the board is wide. And I've got my feather board actually at a bit of a height, so it supports it near the center of the cut. So here's my side pieces. They're still a little thicker than I need to. Most people use a thickness sander. I'm just going to try to use a table saw blade and a rip cut. So I've put a better quality blade in there, and I'll try to cut those half at a time. Next, I need to bend the sides for the ukulele. And to bend wood, it helps to apply moisture and to apply heat. And I figured a steam iron would be ideal for that. But when I tried to bend it around the tight radiuses of the form that I had, I actually got some cracking in some places. So I wasn't getting enough heat or steam or something. So I figured trying to put the wood between a hot stove plate and the iron would give me more heat. And I had some success with that. But the problem is, I was applying too much heat and some of the wood started to discolor a bit. So I figured actual steam was the way to go, and so next I tried a turkey roasting pan. And after a few minutes, that really softened up the wood. So a problem I've got is even if I let this dry for a day, once I release it out of the clamps, it springs back quite considerably. So to try to gauge what the curvature is, I made a radius gauge out of a dial indicator so I can measure what the effective radius of curvature is. So the way this works is the dial indicator just reads in here, and if it's against a flat object, it reads zero. But if it's against a curved object, the thing in the middle is not quite level. And so in this case, it reads 50. And to work out the radius, I take 500 and divide that by the reading on here. So divide by 50. So that says I should have a radius of 10 centimeters here. So let's check that. And we have 19 and a half centimeters across. So very close to that radius, but it also varies quite a bit around the edge. It's not a perfect circle, so close enough. So now I can use my radius gauge to figure out how much spring back I'm actually getting here. So right now this is reading 105 while it's clamped. Now I don't even have to convert that to a radius because I'll just use that as a curvature. And now if I unclamp that, and going back to the same pencil mark, I now get about 83. And that is about a 20% relaxation, which is pretty close to what I've been getting measuring one of these in many, many places after unclamp it. So I wanted to create a bending form that once the strip is unclamped, it'll come out to roughly this shape. So I want the bending form to be about 20% tighter than the final shape. So I took the shape and approximated it as a series of circular arcs.
And then I took each of these arcs and made the radius 20% tighter and drew a shape like this in the CAD program, and that was pretty tricky. And so I've got this shape here that hopefully once it relaxes will be closer to this shape here.
So the problem with a roasting pan is that it's barely large enough for a tenor size ukulele. So I had the idea of making a chimney for my rice cooker, and I wrapped that in paper towel for insulation, and that works really well for steaming long parts.
So let's see how this matches. It's not bang on, but it's pretty close, and it only takes a minor bit of force to get it to actually match. So I'm satisfied with that result.